And go second substitute House Bill 1365 on third reading and final passage. Remarks, a member from the 33rd District, Representative Gregerson.
Good morning, Mr. Speaker. I rise asking you to join me in supporting this legislation. It's one of the most important topics that I think we could be considering this year. Last year when we left for Sine Die, that was about 11 months ago, at the same time, our educators, our families, and our students went into remote learning overnight. At that point in time, we had over 100,000 students without a learning device, and it kept growing throughout the last 11 months. I'm proud of so many people, including the good gentleman from the 8th District, who met week after week to roll up our sleeves to meet with so many others from different parts of the sector to learn about the problem and to come up with solutions that would work for immediate response. But the reality is, even today, we have nearly 100,000 students without devices that are working, or they don't have the digital literacy skills or the tech support that's necessary in order for them to learn from home. You've heard from the governor and others that learning loss is a really important issue and that we need to do whatever we can to get in control of that, to learn from this and do better, and that once the pandemic is over, we're prepared to go into remote learning again. Now, I know that school districts all around the state have been doing a wonderful job. Rural districts have different unique problems than suburban districts. And there are tech levies that are coming up at different points in time, and they choose what to do with those dollars. But the reality is that a one-to-one initiative is critically important at this point in time to ensure that all students have a learning device that is adequate for their needs. Now, I know that some are overwhelmed by the cost, but if we will pay now or we'll pay later. We are known for being a state of having so many tech opportunities. We are a state home of some of the most globally powerful tech companies in the world. But when the Keep America Pledge ended at the end of June, we were all scrambling to procure devices and ensure that the students have what they need. But even still today, we have not fixed the problem. So I hope that you will join me today with hopefully others in supporting the state's first one-to-one initiative. This will also ensure that we have collaboration and cooperation by so many other partners that are already doing great work, and we'll be able to execute and prioritize those dollars as they come in. I'm very happy and thankful for so many that have worked on this policy today, and I'm hopeful that you're not overwhelmed by being the first state to consider such an initiative. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.